Little cultivation. Control priest dead by turn four. Hello, Snugglebugs. Welcome to today's Hearthstone video. We're coming at you a little bit of a Treant Druid, and it's gonna be like an aggro druid. Now they're always pretty much in here, but it's gonna focus on Treants and how to summon them, and basically just get a lot of power super quickly. And I think what we're actually gonna do here against Control Priest is just throw out the Blood Treant, throw out the 2/1s, and then that way hopefully we can throw out a Crooked Cook on turn two if we can, you know, hit them in the face for three, and that way we can start getting our draw engine online. Now they have 35 health, so we gotta really be careful on how much we try to smack them for. I'm just gonna go all out here. Draw power. We need to basically try to beat down this Control Priest before they get any of their AoEs online, which of course isn't, you know, super easy. Now we're gonna potentially, or we're gonna hopefully be able to get our Crooked Cook number two down, start hitting them in the face for everything. I mean, all that does is stop the one draw. It's still pretty good, don't get me wrong. It's sort of part of our draw engine, but considering we have number two in our hand, we can just keep going. And it made it so this did one less damage, so obviously not the worst, but definitely, you know, when I buff them up later, it could have been more valuable. Or if I ever get a Soul of the Forest out on this board. Now, if I did get a good board buff, which this is, but I do not have enough mana, this isn't bad. A lot of sins. Okay. What do we have? Lingering Zombie. So we can play the two Treants and play Mark of the Wild. I'm going to play it on the one with the most health here, which might be a mistake seeing their cultivation, giving them effectively just a better target. But I'm hoping they don't have both cultivations in a 40-card deck in the top 8 cards. In fact, they played, not cultivation, what was that card they just played? Consumption? I forget already. I play Priest a lot, and I forget what that card is called. I'm just trying to be aggressive. Be aggressive. Now, right now, this cultivation, because I played a few Treants for 5 mana next turn, will basically give me plus 14, plus 14 if they don't board wipe me here, which they did not. So 2, 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Little cultivation. Control Priest dead by turn 4. Turn 5. That's pretty powerful. I aggressive decks, play them if you want to play them. Subscribe if you want to see more. We're going to go try this again and see if it can, you know, if it's consistent. All right, so far, hand's not quite as consistent as it was last time. Aquatic Form, I think, might be okay. We won't want to keep both Witchwood Apples because we obviously want to draw some of our minions that we can actually play. And on that note, I'm actually going to get rid of Aquatic. You know, I'm going to get rid of it in case it shows me something like a Blood Treant. Conservator Nymph. Transform a Treant into a 5/5 Ancient with Taunt. It's pretty good. Mech Rogue is going to be tough. They're going to be able to get out a lot bigger and a lot faster things than we are. Unfortunately for us, I probably actually should have Living Roots that, to be fair, because now it's going to get to... Ooh, good opportunity. Okay, so here I can actually play 3 Treants. Coin. Deal 2 damage with Living Roots. Now, next turn, I can hit with all 3 and then transform a Treant into a 5/5 with Taunt. Which, I mean, on turn 3, having all that on the board, I mean, a 3/4 anyway is pretty good. 3/4 for 3, and then being able to turn these into a 5/5, fantastic. Mwah. Soul of the Forest is also pretty good once I have, you know, 4 or 5 minions on the board. Prep the Serrated Bone Spike. Makes their next card cost 2 less. Okay. So that kind of makes me want to hold back on this because I'm going to have to do Mark of the Wild here in order to get the... I'm going to have to Mark of the Wild. Yeah, that was a good defense on their part. Because now I'm going to have to Mark of the Wild and trade, and then they can trade in here if they want to and play their replicating guy. I have no way to deal with that. Oh, they don't even have to. Okay, yep. This is the replicating guy too. Now they got a coin. So yeah, I mean, it does look like Mech Rogue might be much more aggressive than even this deck is, which is obviously unfortunate. I mean, we can play our Blood Treant and then turn it into a 5/5 with Taunt. The only thing is they're going to become, what is that going to be? 9/6. That gives them a coin. They're not gonna, okay, they're not playing that yet. Interesting enough. Okay. I mean, interesting. And if they're just going to re-dagger, I can actually hit and play my draw engine now. I'm kind of surprised. I get that they're being a little bit greedy, but might be too greedy in my mind. Sure. Give me another treant. Draw me another card. Cultivation. Yeah. Here we go. A little soul of the forest, a little cultivation. Next turn, maybe a little bit of both. Yeah, I mean, now they're getting out there. Gear shift draws them some cards. The only thing is, if this creates a replication, they're gonna have lethal on me. Is the problem. So in order to take this out, I can't even take out both. Taunt is okay, right? Because taunt will make them have a hard time. Yeah, I mean, I don't know how good this is. I mean, it's all we got right now. Puts enough of a wall that both their divine shields maybe have to hit this. Ah, nope. Shucks, if they get a poisonous rush, taunt. Oh, and the taunt is going to duplicate itself too. They could have won here though, I think, based on what I've seen, but that's all right. It does go to show you, though, that even though we did pretty good, this start was actually a lot better than I thought. Mech Rogue is still the boss. They're going to get four minions out here. I'll let them do their thing. I'll let them kill us here next turn. Yep, duplicate. No point in me, like, I'll just show off what we can do here. Why not? Get us a little 2-2. Trade in. And then the Mech Rogue just shows us who is truly the boss when it comes to aggro. Thank you very much for that. I appreciate it, Belta Geese. And yeah, I mean, as you can see, this deck isn't the best, but it's super quick. This is a budget deck. There's like, oh, there's no epics, I don't even think, in here. Just all rares, commons, a lot of which are just, you know, easy to come across if you don't have them already. So for fast climbing, this is a good deck. Obviously, the Mech Rogue, our opponent played, is also a really aggressive deck for fast legendary climbing. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. I know this was a short one, but I'll see you in the next one.